All right, so next one is broken object property level authorization. So we mentioned before this idea of broken object level authorization. So that's the ability to access resources that don't belong to you. In this case, the idea is having access to properties in those objects that you shouldn't be able to access, to modify, or to read. So it happens in two ways. This vulnerability in 2023 brings together two vulnerabilities of the 2019 edition, which are mass assignment and excessive data exposure. So excessive data exposure is when you are leaking more information than you should to the users of your application. If you're thinking of a medical application, for example, you may be leaking patient records or details about the patients that certain users shouldn't be able to see. In terms of mass assignment, is the ability of a user to overwrite what we call server-side or read-only properties. So if you think, for example, here of an e-commerce application, you place an order, the order hasn't been paid yet, the status of the order is unpaid. If a user sees this property through the API and they try to override it and they manage to do it, then that's when we have a mass assignment broken object property level authorization breach in our API. So what do you think, Frank, we can do here to prevent this problem?
I'd say first things first, kind of starting from an outside-in approach with regards to how you design the API is a good way for making sure that you will only expose data that's needed to solve the intended problem. So you're not just exposing all data that you have. So if indeed you're then exposing operations that are more for reading, and make sure you're kind of limiting that down, that you're not exposing maybe kind of server-side properties that might be used to manipulate other endpoints. You can use maybe patterns like CQRS as well to kind of separate the reading and the more command-based operations against your API and have different schemas being used. So I think they're all kind of approaches that I would see as being common and to try to mitigate this type of issue.